housing, and part of what is pushing families to move there is the Folsom Cordova Unified School District. It has some of the best schools in the nation. Now school district officials are trying to alleviate overcrowding, and part of that solution is moving students from Vista Del Lago to Folsom. So we're going to talk more about this with Daniel Thigpen, Director of Communication and Community Engagement for Folsom Cordova Unified School District. Thanks so much for being here. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, so I talked about your district having some of the best schools in the nation. That's a great thing, but it also comes with a lot of folks wanting to move to the area to have their kids enrolled in your schools.
Absolutely. You know, we're very fortunate. We're a growing district. Mm-hmm. We have amazing educators, amazing support staff, and great students and families. I think one thing you mentioned, overcrowding at Vista Del Lago, I think one thing that's important to recognize is that we actually have enough capacity at both of our high schools for all of our existing families and students in Folsom right now, both at Folsom High and Vista Del Lago. What we were dealing with was not necessarily a capacity issue as it relates to the school, but a feeder pattern issue. So where were the kids coming from elementary to middle to high school? So we spent months working with our families and our community and our staff on that. It was very collaborative. Obviously, that's a difficult conversation to have, but we found a solution. It's probably going to be about, you know, 3 more years of some pretty tight enrollment there, but after a couple of years, people will start to see some relief. And in the meantime, we're breaking ground on our first new school in a new housing development in over a decade.
So you talked about sort of the issue here because people just think overcrowding and it's one school. So talk about the layers here from elementary to middle school and how parents kind of plan this out for their kids.
Sure. The conversation starts before kindergarten. Mm-hmm. What are your social groups going to be? What activities are you going to participate in? Where's your carpool going to be in your neighborhood? And so certainly understanding that families spend a lot of time planning that on behalf of their child's education, we wanted to work with them and try to create a soft landing if we were going to be making any changes that would disrupt those plans. So we have one school, it's called Blanche Sprentz Elementary in Folsom, that is going to be rerouting to Sutter Middle School and then Folsom High School. So they'll be able to follow their same cohort of friends to the middle school and then to the high school. That'll give us a little bit of a relief valve at Vista Del Lago in a few years, and while allowing them to maintain their social contacts and their activities with their friends.
So there was some rezoning, is that the right term to use, that went on in order to have this plan come to fruition?
It was an adjustment of the attendance boundary,
okay.
Correct.
So when a community decides that it needs, like you talked about, opening a new school, talk about that process and how you guys come to that decision.
Sure. Well, we work really closely with our city planners, mm-hmm. with the developers and property owners in the community and within our boundaries. We have been for many, many years, understanding that there is very large scale growth projected over the next 5, 10, 20 years, both in Folsom and in Rancho Cordova, which we also serve, and south of that Highway 50 corridor. So we have about 50 students already in the Folsom Ranch area, south of 50, that are attending some of our schools that have enough capacity to hold them until we open new schools. That would be Folsom High, Folsom Middle School, and Gallardo Elementary. Most of those students are elementary right now, but we're going to be breaking ground in February in our first new elementary school, Mangini Ranch mm-hmm. Elementary. And ultimately, south of 50 in Folsom, we're looking at 5 new elementary schools, a middle, and a high school.
Wow, 5, that is a lot. So that, I mean, your community is booming.
And that's one
that's
side.
That's not
of
hyperbole.
The, correct. And that's one side of the district. If you look in Rancho Cordova and the Rio del Oro planned mm-hmm. area, we're looking at 6 new elementary schools, 2 middle schools, and another high school. That's all dependent on the rate of growth and how many people are buying new homes, but we stay in constant contact to make sure we have enough capacity in all of our facilities for our new homeowners and their kids.
And you talked about how parents plan this out starting from kindergarten and they go into elementary and middle school. I imagine that you heard from a lot of parents that were concerned that their kids would possibly have to go to a different school. So how did you guys communicate with them? You held a lot of meetings, I assume, and heard from the public.
We wanted to create a transparent, two-way, and collaborative process that evolved along with our family's input. Mm-hmm. So what we did almost a year ago was start that conversation, let people know what problem are we trying to solve. We'd certainly had an enrollment issue that was impacting the facility at Vista Del Lago. And we wanted to allow people enough time to plan, given that we understood that there could be a disruption to some of those families. Mm-hmm. So we did surveys. We did a lot of communication via text message, email, direct to families, our social media pages. And then we did hold a lot of in-person, we called them work sessions, not necessarily forums, because what we were trying to do was not necessarily just gather input, but get people working together and bringing some ideas to the table, because we don't always have all of the answers. Sometimes the answers come from the community as well.
So talk about long-term too. You know, we talked about this a little bit. You're anticipating Folsom continuing to grow. If the school district has this reputation. So how do you, get even more ahead of the curve down the road?
Well, again, I think that work started years ago. Mm-hmm. It was understanding that we were going to have a lot of new homes coming up. Mm-hmm. The city of Folsom has its master plan. And so understanding that as people are building homes and buying homes, that they're going to be bringing and raising children with them, and they need to be educated. So we make sure that we have a seat at the table. We have great partnerships with both the cities of Folsom and Rancho Cordova to sit down and talk about what are the demographics and trends and things we typically need to plan for to provide enough public school capacity for those families.
What can the state do too? How can they be involved, do you think?
Well, certainly, you know, we have the ability to build new schools because mm-hmm. of being able to issue bonds. Mm-hmm. And the state has an opportunity, or we often sometimes have the opportunity to get matching funds depending on what the state's able to provide. So that's always a part of the equation. And I think that as we're continuing to look at our financing and ability to do that, that's always going to be a factor.
Daniel Thigpen, we appreciate you coming in on a Friday evening and chatting with us about this.
Thank you very much. Happy to be here.
Eric, over to you.
Nikki, thanks. Congress is working to lower interest rates on consumer loans.